exercise video today. I hope you are keeping well and I hope you're keeping safe and healthy. So today we're going to get started by warming up. So I'm going to get you to shuffle your bottom forward so you're on the edge of the seat. Okay, we shouldn't be sitting at the back of the chair, we should be away from the back of the chair, and we're simply going to start off by just gently lifting our heels. So we started off 2 or 3 sessions ago just doing our heel lifts, but we're starting to make it a little bit harder. If you should be doing this on a regular basis, maybe a couple of times a week. So let's see if we can take it a little bit harder, and let's see if we can lift our feet off the floor. Remember, if you can, it's absolutely fine. You can take it back to just lifting the heels off the floor. So if you can't manage to march, just do that option. But if you're able, let's pick it up a little bit. Good, we're also going to add in those arms now as well. So just lifting the feet off the floor, moving the arms, and getting that blood moving around the body. Good, so nice and smooth, nice and controlled. Don't be rushing it too much. Good, excellent, well done. Okay, we're going to stop there and we're going to tap and clap. So nice and smooth. Tapping your thighs and clapping the hands. Again, remember to sit up nice and tall for me. Good. Okay, let's make it a little bit harder. Let's do it out to the sides. Good. Couple more for me. And last one. Well done. Okay, let's take it back to that marching for me. Good. So gently lifting the feet off the floor, just peeling those toes off, and then moving the arms. This just helps with the movement in your shoulders as well. Good. And then let's go back to taps and claps. Again, out to the side if you can. So don't rush it, just nice and controlled. Okay, let's do 4 more. 3 more. 2 more for me. Good. And last one. Excellent. Good. Now we're going to do a row. So we're going to start with our hands here. And we're going to imagine that we're pulling that oar back down by our side. And again, this just gently works your waist and gets the shoulders moving. So let me see you. Come on, get those arms moving. Good. Again, try not to do it too fast. Nice and smooth and nice and controlled. Good. Keep that good pace going. Excellent. Good. Okay, we're going to repeat all them three exercises. We're going to repeat them all once more, and then we're going to add some mobility and some stretches in for you today. So something we've not done before is our stretches. So we're going to add 2 or 3 in for you, just for something a little bit different. So we're going to go back and repeat all our warm-up movements, just to keep that blood moving. Good. So lifting those feet up. Again, remember to sit nice and tall. Who's slumped over or who's managed to get their bum to the back of the chair? Good. So I might not be there in person, but I know you'll have your bum at the back of the chair. So let's stay forward and stay nice and tall. Good. And then let's do our taps and claps. Again, nice and smooth, nice and controlled. So out to the side, just adding that little twist. And let's do 4 more. 3, 2, and last. one, everybody. Excellent. And then the last one we've got to do is our canoeing. So hands in front, gently moving the arms. Good. So again, keep it nice and controlled. Try not to do it too fast. Remember, you work at your own pace. Good. Couple more for me. Well done. Last one on either side. Excellent. Good work. How are we feeling? Is everybody all right? Good. So we're going to do a couple of mobility exercises and then we're going to do a couple of stretches for something a little bit different. So what we're going to start with is our trunk twists. We'll do one mobility for the upper body and we'll do one mobility for the lower body. So with our hands on top of each other, again sitting up nice and tall, we're going to ease round. We're going to take our head to look over our shoulder and then we're going to come back to the centre. And you're going to ease round to the other side and then come back to the centre. Let's repeat that again. So round to the first side. Remember, you take the head to look over your shoulder, back to the centre, and then ease round to the other side. Excellent. Well done. How did you find that? Did you find that okay? Good. We're now going to lift the shoulders up to our ears and then let them drop down. Up to our ears and then let them drop down. Up to the ears and let them drop down. Up to the ears and then let those shoulders drop. Excellent, well done. Okay, we're now going to do a little bit of mobility for our ankles. So I'm going to get you to sit in the back of the chair for this one, so you're allowed to shuffle back. So sit back in the chair for me. Excellent. Top part of your legs is supported. We're just going to gently extend one leg out in front and you're going to point the toe down the way and then you're going to pull that toe up to your shin. So again, repeating that, point the toe down the way and then pull it up to your shin. Can you notice that I'm doing at my foot? Pull it up, point it down and pull it up. One more. Excellent. Okay, we're going to change legs. So we're going to do the same on the opposite leg. So stretch that leg out in front and then point the toe down to the floor and then pull the toe back up. Point the floor down and then just pull it back up. Again, just do it as best you can. You might have limited movement in your ankles and that's absolutely fine. As long as you're doing your best, that's all we ask. Good. So let's do two more. So point the toes, pull it back, point the toes and pull it back. Excellent. Good. Okay, now we're going to move on to that first leg again. So stretch it out, but instead of point and pull, we're going to circle the ankle. So nice big ankle circles. Make them as big as you can. And we're just going to do a few in one direction and then we're going to stop. And we're going to go in the opposite direction. So again, try not to move your leg. It's just your ankle and making those circles as big as you can. Well done. Okay, rest there. And we're going to do the same on the other leg. So we're going to swap legs. Stretch that leg out. And again, start by circling the ankle in one direction. It doesn't matter what direction. Don't worry about it. So nice big circles, nice and slow and controlled. And then let's stop there. And let's go in the opposite direction. Well done. Good. One more. Excellent. Well done, everybody. How are we feeling? Are we feeling okay? Good. Let's take a nice deep breath in. And then slowly breathe out. And then let's take another nice deep breath in. And then let's slowly breathe out. Good. Okay, we're going to move on to do our stretches. So the first stretch we're going to do is for our legs. And it's going to be for the backs of our legs. And we call them your hamstrings. But you just need to know they're the back of your legs. So So that's the muscle we're going to stretch. So we're going to shuffle forwards to the edge of the seat now. Okay, we're going to keep one foot firmly on the floor and the other leg we're going to take it out in front. So you're going to stretch that leg and you're going to stretch that leg out just as best you can. Yeah, if you've got stiff knees or stiff ankles, just do what you can do. So from there, you're going to put your hands on the other knee. Yeah, so the foot that's firmly on the floor, plant your hands on the top of that thigh. We're going to sit nice and tall and we're going to ease forward from the hips. And your hands are on that top thigh for a little bit of support and you should be feeling that stretch up the back of your leg. We're going to hold that stretch for up to 10 seconds and you might feel it at the back of your knee as well, depending on how tight your leg is. So a couple more seconds and ease back. Good. Okay, we're going to change legs now, so swap over. I'll just turn my chair around. So again, sitting in the front, extending one foot forward. Remember, your hands go on the other thigh. Yep, don't forget to sit up tall. And we're going to ease forward from the hips. And you should be feeling that stretch down the back of the thigh. So when you're ready, pop your hands on your supporting leg. And please make sure that supporting foot is firmly flat on the floor. Again, as you ease forward, you should feel a gentle pull up the back of the leg. Holding that for up to 10 seconds, so a couple of seconds more. Good. And ease back. Well done. How did you find that? Yeah, did you find that okay? So that's a new one for you, so you can add that one in whenever you want. And as I say, it's really good for helping you to bend, and it just keeps the flexibility in the back of your legs. So the other one we're going to do is for our shoulders and for our side, and we call it an upward side stretch. So you're going to take one hand, pop it on the shoulder, and use your spare arm to lift that up. From there, you're going to reach up, pop your hand on the side of the chair for support if you need it, and then bring that hand back down. Okay, we're going to do the same on the other side. So again, that opposite hand goes on the same shoulder. Use your spare arm to lift the elbow up if it needs it. Reach up, and again, imagine you're reaching up into a cupboard. For support, you can pop the hand on the side of the chair if you need it, and really stretch up. Well done. And then bring that arm back down. Good. Okay, just relax, get yourself sorted. Take a nice deep breath. Breathing in through the nose, breathing out through the mouth. Excellent. Okay, we're going to sit in the back of the chair today. Good. And we're just going to do a little bit of coordination now, just to finish off, just to keep that mind going. Okay, so we're going to double tap the thighs and double clap. So it's double tap, double clap. Good. So just seeing what you can remember from the previous video. Excellent. So to this, we're going to add on. So you keep that going, and I'm going to show you the next bit now. So it's double tap, double clap, and then we take one hand on top, then below. Yep, so it's double tap, double clap, one hand on top, then below. Double tap, double clap. Join in with me now. Good. Double tap, double clap, one hand on top, then below. Double tap, double clap. Good. Let's do that once more. Double tap, double clap, one hand on top. Good. Now I'm going to add on. So watch it here. After the one hand on top, we're going to do mashed potato, mashed potato, mashed potato, mashed potato. So all together, it goes double tap, double clap, one hand on top, then below. Mashed potato, mashed potato, mashed potato. Okay, you guys joining now. So it's taps and claps, and then one hand on top and then below. And now you're mashed potato. Good, let's do that again. Taps and claps. One hand on top, then below. Now it's mashed potato. Good. And again, last time. Double tap, double clap, Good. Mashed potato time. Well done, and relax that there. Excellent. How did you find that? Yeah, again, that's one that you can do at any point in the day. It gets your brain thinking, it gets your arms thinking. You know, you've got to move your hands, tapping your thighs. It's a little bit of coordination and keeping your mind active, which is so important right now. So that's us finished up for the day. We're just going to finish up completely just with a gentle little march on the spot, just to cool down for a minute or so. Good, so it's not too fast. Again, think about our breathing. Take a nice deep breath in, and then slowly breathe out. Good, and then march in those arms. Good, and then just gently lifting the heels off the floor. Good. Excellent. And just gently rest there. One more deep breath in, breathe in through the nose, out through the mouth. Give yourself a huge clap. Good, well done today for doing your exercises. Just want to thank you again for coming on. Have a super day. Keep staying safe, keep staying active, and we'll see you all soon. Thank you.